with a kind of an edition of Rabbi E in 3D, brought to you as always by MEOR DC. And this is a bit spontaneous. I wanted to come outside. It's beautiful. Maybe it's a little bit wishful thinking to have declared that spring has arrived, but it's coming. And I actually like the cold or cool, brisk air. I like cold air actually also, but I'm in the backyard. I'm in my Shabbos clothes. Shabbos is coming. I have a timer going. This is not one of those Rabbi Ian 3Ds that goes on and on and on. You know, I don't always have to come out here with something profound. I don't think I ever come out with anything profound, but this is a my sincere wishes to you for a wonderful Shabbos, and I will tie it in very quickly to the Torah portion. It's a massive Torah portion, Ki Sisa, in the book of Exodus. It's the golden calf, the cataclysmic event in Jewish history. Hard to fathom what went on. It was not wholesale idolatry by most of the Jewish people. Understand that if you study it closely. Some people were panicking that Moshe had delayed coming down the mountain. They were looking for a leader. Some people worshipped idols. Some people were partying. A horrible cataclysmic event. However, it was followed by the incredible teshuva, the repentance of the Jewish people, and the revelation to the world of one of the most beautiful prayers, really, we utter, or the and concepts, the 13 attributes of mercy. So that we invoke on Yom Kippur and other times of trouble as we cry out to God. So from the darkness came a lot of light. But I don't really have anything more to say about that part of the Torah portion. That's your assignment over Shabbos. You delve into it. The darkness of the golden calf, the beautiful light and reconciliation of the Jewish people and God. Very beautiful. But I did want to share one thing about Shabbos. Shabbos is also in the Torah portion, not coincidentally, I'm sure. Nothing's coincidental. Meaning, in addition to the opposite of the cataclysmic constricted consciousness, if you will, of the golden calf and everything represented is the light and illumination of Shabbos. And one of the most beautiful descriptions of Shabbos being an eternal covenant between the Jewish people, a special sign between us and God, is in this week's Torah portion too. Shabbos is a gift. It's beautiful. And here's the thought I wanted to share. You know, I came to this thought, I saw in a beautiful book talking about Yom Kippur by a very holy rabbi who said something that applies to Shabbos too in a different way. He said that every single second, every instant of Yom Kippur is infused with the incredible spiritual elevation of Yom Kippur. In that case, the special energy of repentance and atonement. Meaning every second of Yom Kippur atones, every second of Yom Kippur purifies. It's not something like you do it and at the end you get like this retroactive purification. Every second's purifying. Shabbos, every second of it is holy. Every second of it is special. It's 25 hours of living in a different world, a world infused with more spirituality. Even the way it describes Shabbos in this week's Torah portion, it alludes to that, uses a word that Hashem made the world in 6 days and then, so to speak, different ways of translating vayinafash, but infused extra spirituality into the world. And certainly we know that from the beginning of creation, or the first 7 days of creation, 6 days of creation, then Shabbos, Hashem blessed the Sabbath day, made it holy. Every single second, in other words, of Shabbos is holy. By the way, Jewish people were given a special neshama, an extra soul to appreciate that holiness. But here's my point, and I'm really going to stop. Believe it or not, Rabbi E can stop. Like Hashem stopped, ha! Haha, Hashem stopped, I can withdraw, I can hold back. Every second is Shabbos. Let's say you're not ready to, you know, do a whole Shabbos. Maybe you don't even have Kiddush prepared. Maybe you don't have a meal. Every second of the 25 hours, I don't know how many seconds that is, do the math, is Shabbos. And that means if you stop and just think, right? Everyone's into, in a good way, mindfulness and meditation. It's such a useful tool in our world. Shabbos is a day of mindfulness par excellence. That's very much the meaning of it. The world is infused with mindfulness and soulfulness. But the point is, so you don't have time to do a whole Friday night meal or your other things. Stop for 60 seconds and think and say, it's Shabbos. Lot of 60-second opportunities in 25 hours to stop and acknowledge it's Shabbos. People are not always at the point of, I'm observing Shabbos full Shomer Shabbat, etc. It's a wonderful thing to get to. I believe it's the most beautiful day of the week. I can't live without it. It's incredible. But even if you're not observant of the whole Shabbos, stop and observe a few minutes or seconds of Shabbos. Think about something deeper that you don't think about during the week. Learn Torah. meditate. It's the day that is the opportunity for spiritual growth and elevation. I've already gone beyond my time. That's all I wanted to share with you, that idea that just like every second of the 25 hours of Yom Kippur purifies, every second of the 25 hours of Shabbos is holy and blessed and full of a special illumination and a special potential that we have to go deeper, to see farther, to be more calm and mindful. If we have that capacity, every little bit of it is beautiful. Thank you for listening, and really, good Shabbos. That's really what I had to say. Oh, and you can check out my latest Rabbi Ian 3 podcast, where I bare my soul on why I'm really doing the podcast. That's Rabbi Ian 3 podcast, but this was wonderful to be with you, Rabbi Ian 3D, outside on a breezy day. Shabbat shalom, good Shabbos.